Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I hope this message reaches one and all in good health, amnesty, and prosperity, insha'Allah. Honorable listeners, one of the differentiating factors between us and our Salafi Saliheen, our pious predecessors, is that they exploited and utilized the opportunity to gain ilm objectively, to gain knowledge objectively, and we neglect it casually. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the noble Quran, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ, chapter 39, verse number 9, that O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say that those who possess ilm, those who have knowledge, and those who don't, can they be equal? The great Imam of the Ummah by the name of Imam al-Shafi'i rahimahullah said, تَعَلَّمْ فَلَيْسَ الْمَرْءُ يُولَدُ عَالِمًا. Acquire knowledge, because no one is born a scholar, no one is born learned. So the zeal and the enthusiasm to gain ilm every day should be paramount in the life of every believer. With that being said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us a golden opportunity. 2020, the month of Ramadan, it's a golden opportunity to one and all to reform our lives, to rejuvenate our lives, and to become better believers. My Honorable Shaykh Hafidhullah said that the example of Ramadan in the 12 months is like the example of Yusuf alayhi salam amongst his 12 brothers. And if you study the life of our pious predecessors and Sahaba radiallahu anhum in particular, their lives revolved around the month of Ramadan. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ يَعْلَمُ الْعِبَادُ مَا فِي رَمَضَانِ لَتَمَنَّتْ أُمَّتِي أَن تَكُونَ السَّنَةُ كُلُّهَا رَمَضَانِ. If only people knew what the month of Ramadan holds within itself, the grandeur of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, people would yearn and people would pine out that the entire month was Ramadan. With that being said, we have an opportunity today. Inshallah, there will be a series of lectures on the topic of Ramadan, what to do in the month of Ramadan, how to abstain from sins, what's the fadail of Ramadan, so forth and so on. And there are various topics that can be discussed in the month of Ramadan, the ibadat of Ramadan. As believers, we know that we are clumsy, we have feebleness, we have weakness. We think about it, we make that determination, but sometimes it doesn't have dawam and istiqamah and steadfastness. So the month of Ramadan comes, we try, but then we say, okay, let's wait for Laylatul Qadr, or rather, let's wait for the last 10 nights. The last 10 nights come, then we say, let's wait for Laylatul Qadr. And sadly, the month of Ramadan comes and goes without our lives, and without our lives changing and being closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have this opportunity today to learn about the month of Ramadan, to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to rekindle our ta'alluq of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to rejuvenate our souls and get the qurb of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and become maghfoor and forgiven in the month of Ramadan, and start a new chapter of our lives. In the lockdown, we can make the best of this month of Ramadan and make this azam and firm determination today that I will make this 2020 Ramadan the best Ramadan of our lives. Like someone said, between the regrets of yesterday and the future of tomorrow lies the opportunity of today. So let us make this azam. In the description there is a link. There will be a link that will be shared, inshallah. Click the link and there will be a form. Get your names and sign up for it, inshallah, for these series of lectures, and share with others, inshallah, with the intention of reward. All the reward that they will do, all the knowledge that they will gain, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it in our accounts also. With that being said, I'll leave you with this last quotation. Yesterday was history, tomorrow is mystery, and the present is a gift. That's why they call it the present. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.